We will discuss how to find solution of a partial differential equation by direct integration. So these are the two problems we will be discussing now. So consider the first problem. So you have to solve dou square u by dou x dou t equal to e raised to minus t cos x. So in this case, u is the dependent variable, x and t are independent variables. So we can integrate this equation directly with respect to x and t. Okay, so first we will integrate equation number 1 partially with respect to x. Then dou u by dou t is equal to, so when you are integrating with respect to x, we will consider t as a constant. So therefore, it is e raised to minus t into integral of cos x is sin x plus constant of integration, that is the function in the other variable. So in this case, we integrated with respect to x, therefore constant of integration will be a function in t. So now again we integrate this equation number 2 with respect to x. So in this case, after integrating this equation number 2 with respect to t, u is equal to, now integral of e raised to minus t, that is minus e raised to minus t into sin x is constant, sin x plus integral of ft dt plus constant of integration, that is constant of integration is a function in the other variable. So in this case it is gx. Now in this case, integral ft dt will be a function in a t again. So we can use any other name to represent that one. So we can write u as u equal to minus e raised to minus t sin x plus integral ft dt, I will write it as ht dt, ht plus g of x. So this is the required solution for the given differential equation. So since the differential equation is of second order, the solution contains two arbitrary functions, that is ht and g of x. Now consider this second problem. Here we have to solve d square z by dou x square equal to a square z with respect to some conditions. So then in this case we can see that it is a homogeneous partial differential equation. Homogeneous partial differential equation means each term of the partial differential equation contains either dependent variable or its partial derivatives. So this is a homogeneous partial differential equation and it contains partial derivatives with respect to only one independent variable. Such type of functions can be solved by treating this as an ordinary differential equation. So here, since this contains partial derivatives only in x, we will consider y as a constant. So, y as a constant. And then this partial differential equation can be written as an ordinary differential equation as d square z by dy x square, that is equal to a square z. Now then we can use any known method for solving this ordinary differential equation, and we know that this is a linear differential equation. So therefore we can write auxiliary equation here. In this case, this can be written as d square z by dx square minus a square z equal to 0. Therefore, in this case, auxiliary equation is d square minus a square equal to 0. This gives d equal to plus or minus a. So, roots of the auxiliary equation are real and distinct. Therefore, solution of this ordinary differential equation denoted by equation number 2 is z is equal to c1 into e raised to ax plus c2 into e raised to minus ax. But in this case, since we have treated y as a constant, this arbitrary constant c1 and c2 can be functions of y. Therefore, instead of writing c1 and c2, we can write this z as f of y e raised to ax plus g of y e raised to minus ax. So, this is the solution of the given partial differential equation. So, we can write it as fy e raised to ax plus gy e raised to minus ax. At this step, we will use this initial conditions for evaluating this arbitrary functions. So, the first initial condition is dou z by dou x is a sin y when x is equal to 0. So, we can write it is given that dou z by dou x is equal to a sin y and dou z by dou y equal to 0 when x equal to 0. So, now from equation number 3, we have to find dou z by dou x and dou z by dou y. So, dou z by dou x is equal to, now then differentiate equation number 3 with respect to x. So, we can write it as a into f of y into e raised to ax plus, now gy is derivative of the second term is minus a into gy into e raised to minus ax. Now, dou z by dou y it can be written as f dash y e raised to ax plus g dash y e raised to minus ax. Now, then use these conditions here. So, therefore, we can write a sin y is equal to a f y, x is 0. So, we can write a f y minus a into g y. I will take it as equation number 4. And now, next condition, that is dou z by dou y is 0. Therefore, this is 0 is equal to f dash y plus g dash y. Now, for this is my equation number 5. Now, then we have to evaluate this or eliminate f y, g y, f dash y, g dash y. Therefore, I will obtain one more equation from equation number 4 by differentiating that one. So, we can cancel this a everywhere. So, after cancelling, we will get like this. Now, differentiating equation number 4, we can write cos y is equal to f dash y minus g dash y. Now, you see equation number 5 and 6 are two equations in f dash y and g dash y. So, we can solve these two equations. So, you can add and subtract. Okay. So, therefore, solving equation 5 and 6. By adding 5 plus 6, that gives cos y is equal to 2 f dash y. So, this implies f dash y is equal to cos y by 2. Now, then again subtracting. So, that is equation number 5 minus equation number 6, that gives minus cos y is equal to 2 g dash y This implies g dash y is equal to minus cos y by 2. So we got f dash y and g dash y. From these two, we can find out f y and g y. So therefore, integrate it. Therefore, integrating f y is equal to 1 by 2 into sin y plus constant of integration c1. In this case, this contains only one function. Therefore, integrating that constant of integration will be a mere constant. So we can write it as c1. Similarly, gy is equal to minus 1 by 2 sin y plus c2. So we got the values of arbitrary functions. So now if you are substituting these arbitrary functions in equation number 3, we will get the required solution. Therefore, now we substitute in equation number 3. So we have z is equal to 1 by 2 into sin y plus c1 into e raised to ax plus minus 1 by 2 into sin y plus c2 into e raised to minus ax. We can simplify and write it as sin y into 1 by 2 into e raised to ax minus 1 by 2 into e raised to minus ax, that is sin h ax, plus second term is c1 e raised to ax plus c2 e raised to minus ax. So this is the required solution.